Good morning, students. Now again, we are here on our online classes. As you know that we have started our online classes on our 1st of July, that is on from yesterday, day before yesterday, okay? And even the main thing is that in this, you have to be regular on your studies, beta. Because if you are not regular on your studies, then it will be harmful for you only, because we don't know the what is the limit of this lockdown. If it is extending after July or it may be not. We don't have any kind of ideas as the number of the persons of the infected persons of COVID-19 has been increases day by day. So we don't have. So the only thing through which we all are connected to our education is the online classes. Okay? And if you are facing any kind of a problem and doubt, you may just ask to us. We are there to help you out. But you have to be regular on your online classes, beta. And do your work which is provided you of each and every subject. So after that, as the school will reopen, okay, then you will not be have a workload. Okay? Because right now our most 2 or 3 chapters has been completed on your April month. Now we have started again. Now in July month also we have about to cover 2 or 3 chapters. So the 6 chapters work you are having. So when the school will reopen and if you haven't completed your work, then you are having a lots of workload. Okay, so you have to be regular, complete your work as the chapter has been completed as you are doing previously when we are physically present on the school. Clear? Now in the first chapter, we are having a third lecture today and we have started the first chapter. The name of the first chapter is Crop Production and Management, and in that the introduction portion we have completed. I have just been given you the activities. 3 activities are there, but from that 2 activities are such type of the activities which is possible for you to do at your home only. Okay, no need to visit the field, beta. I am not saying that you have to be visit any kind of the agriculture field. No, if it is possible, if it has been there for you that you can be easily do that activity, because this was activity lots of the students and even many of the students are just learn various thing through activities only. Okay, so you may. Clear? Now we are starting with this. The next topic is our crop season. We are starting from this topic, that is our crop season. Okay, now in the crop season means the crops has been developed or just be grown in a different season, means they are depending on the seasonal condition, because according to the season the temperature is varying. It means the indirectly we can say that the crop are depending on temperature as well. Okay, so the various crop require different climatic conditions. Different climatic condition and temperature also, beta, for their growth. Clear? So it means for the growth of the crop or the plants, we need a climatic condition, because in the climatic condition, humidity is also be affected. Okay, just be create an important role, and temperature for their growth and the completion of their life cycle. Clear? Okay, now depending on the seasonal condition and time of the growth, there are 2 main crop seasons. How many, beta? 2. 2 main crop seasons in our country. In our India, there are mainly 2 crop season. Okay, first one is your kharif crop. Okay, even you have studied about the kharif and rabi crop in your previous classes. Now again we are having its basic introduction, that what is kharif crop. Now the kharif crop, these are sown in the rainy season. In which season, beta? In the rainy season of the month June. Remember the month, beta, because it has been asked in your board exam. And harvested around October. It means it may be asked in your exam that on which month the kharif crop has been sown. On June month, in the rainy season, and harvested on the October month. Okay, examples are paddy, peas in pea, that is arhar, maize, cotton, soya bean and groundnut. These are the rainy season's crop which has been sown on the month of June and harvested around October. This is our rainy season time. Now the second one is your rabi crop. Now in the rabi crop, these are sown in the winter season. As the kharif season, the kharif crop has been completed after harvesting, then the second rabi crop has been sown, okay, on the month of October and harvested around April. Okay, so this is the winter time. For example, wheat, gram, peas, mustard, linseed, oilseed, barley, these all are the examples of rabi crop. Even you have to be remember four examples of each type of the crop because it is very much useful and even it is has been asked in your exam also. So for today's homework, I am just be telling you, yes, we are doing the back exercise question answer also, but in between also some of the basic question we have made by our own. So it will be helpful for you. You having extra questions bank, question bank you have been collected. Okay, so you have to do the first question is that differentiate between kharif crop and rabi crop with four examples each. This is your first question. So you have to make a table. As the word differentiate come, it means you have to differentiate the two things because obvious the differentiating the things are in between the two only. So you have to be make a table. On the one side of the table you have to be write kharif, another side you have to write rabi. Now on the month of sown, month of harvested, on the season also, and four example each you have to be write. Clear? This is about your first question. Now moving ahead with our next topic, that is the basic agriculture practice of crop production. Which are the basic practice for the crop production that we have to be know. So the basic production involves a number of activities which are just be involves for the basic agriculture practice for the crop production, like preparation of a soil. First of all, the farmers are preparing the soil, then they are sowing the seeds and like so on. Means we are just, they are having a practicing again and again till the farmer are not able to harvest the crop and store the crop to produce. Okay, they are just be store the crop produce. Now the activities or the task of a farmer perform the cultivate of crop are referred as agriculture practice. Okay, they are just be do the activities and tasks and the farmer perform a cultivate the crop and they are referred on the agriculture practices. So these agriculture tasks are as follows. There are different agriculture tasks. Okay, and here we are having a 5 agricultural tasks. Okay, 5 agriculture tasks. So first is your preparation of soil. First is your preparation of soil means we are just preparing the soil by plowing and leveling it out. We have to level them out. Okay. Second is application of the manure and the fertilizer. We have to be very much careful about the manure and the fertilizer of the crop. Clear? Third one is the weeding. Weeding means we are just removal the weeds, the insects, the germs, the pests which are just be infected our, which has just be harm our crop. Okay, then we are doing harvesting, threshing and winnowing. Okay, after completion of the harvesting we have cut it down, threshing, all the husk and winnowing we are just kept them, means all this process we have done, and afterward we are just be store them out. Okay, at a particular place because both are just be having, because it has been started, the kharif crop has been started rainy season and the rabi crop is after the rainy season. So sometime as the rain has come, so there just be damage or just the moisture, most of the moisture portion has been absorbed by the plants, the crop, so it can be just damage the crop also, the quality of the product also be damaged through that. So we have to be very much careful about this. Clear? So the 5 preparations are there, and according to these 5 preparation we are have to be having our crop production. Okay, so these 5 preparation we have to be do, and according to them only we have to be do our work. Clear? Now the one by one we have to be do. Okay, now here sowing of the seeds and irrigation is remaining beta. Okay, we have to be sow the seeds, okay, and we have to be irrigate them. Clear? Now first point we are going to be start is the preparation of soil. In the preparation of soil, before sowing the seeds, we have to prepare the soil. Okay, so before sowing the seed, it is important to prepare the soil. It is very much important for their plowing and for their level it out. In the previous time, in the Rig Vedic time, the peoples have to use the blocks, bulls, oxen for the plowing the field. But nowadays, tractor is there, which has been make the work convenient for the farmers. Okay, so the preparation of the soil is done by turning and loosening the soil. Have you ever seen? The tractor has been rounded on the entire field, and at the last, some the needle like structure is there. There has been just be what? Turning and loosening the soil. So it will not be even tightened, because as the soil will be tightened, it will not be help us out for just growing or just be give us the best product. Okay, the process of turning and loosening the soil is called the plowing. Okay, what is called? It calls the plowing. The process of turning and loosening the soil is called plowing or tilling. Tilling. Okay, plowing helps the soil in a number of ways. As I told you, it just be help us out, and it is very much useful for the get the better best quality of the crop. Clear? Now the first way is, first is that it helps in loosening the soil so that it can hold more water and air. It can easily absorb more water and air. Second, the loose soil also helps in the growth of earthworm and microbes, which makes the soil rich in nutrients, and it is also easy to mix the fertilizer and manure in the loose soil. If the soil has been tightened, so it will be very much difficult to mix the manure on the soil. So when we are just be making it turning and loosening, we can easily mix up the manure, okay, and fertilizer also. Aerates the soil. The roots can thus breathe easily. If we are loosening the soil, the roots of the crop can easily have a breathe because they have get the space for them. It helps in easy penetration of the roots of seedling. It can easily have their seedling roots, means they can easily penetrate because they need a space for the penetration of their roots. Okay, nutrients. Rich soil is brought up from the lower level of the soil, so the plants can use their nutrients. Okay, means what has been done? As we have just be level them out, we have loosening the soil, the nutrient soil has been present in the lower side, so it has been coming on the upside, so the nutrients also be rich in the soil. After losing them out, it helps in removing the weeds of uprooting them. As we are uprooting them, we have just be removing the weeds also. Those who are just be underneath of that earth, that has been removed by turning them out. Clear? So these are the points. This has been, we have completed. Okay. Now, from tomorrow's lecture, we have just be start how we are plowing or tilling done. How the farmers can plow or till their field. Clear? Till then, your first question is, you have to differentiate between the rabi crop and the kharif crop with the four examples of each. Clear? Okay. Thank you. That's all for today.